So you know I made that rabbit stew?
Mm-hmm.
Did you try any?
Yeah, I had like 3 bowls.
Okay. You know why I made it?
Because it was cold?
Because it's cold.
Yeah.
Yeah. When the weather gets cold, I think about 2 things. Soup.
Coffee.
And a fire.
Hmm.
So we want to tell you guys about our wood stove. Last year, we converted a wood stove insert into a freestanding wood stove.
We had an electric bill issue
last
year, like $300 to $400 a month.
It was a big issue. And other than getting the wood stove, we took multiple steps to get the electric bill down.
But the wood stove is what helped.
But the wood stove helped the most. So my dad had someone who just like wanted to get rid of this wood stove insert. And he went and picked it up and he had it sitting in like an old chicken house warehouse. I don't know, for like maybe 10 years. It was so rusty that one of the doors wouldn't open. We converted it into a freestanding stove and now that's in our basement den.
Just in terms of energy usage, our power bill went from a daily 100 kilowatt hours to 20 to 25 kilowatt hours. And it drastically dropped our bill. So that was a huge help, for sure.
Huge.
Didn't come without some problems along the way.
No.
As is so common with us.
Yeah.
But
none of our projects are as smooth as I play them out in my own mind.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
The wood stove has come with challenges, i.e. starting a fire in the stove, smoke rolling into the house, billowing into the house. It was definitely trial and error. Lots of errors.
Yeah, from wet wood being the problem to not heating the pipe.
A little bit before, as much.
When we figured out all the problems, I don't know if our stack was too short. We decided to extend the length of the pipe at one point.
We replaced the cap on it
with I forget. Golly.
It's called a stack. Vacuum stack,
yeah. Yep.
That was expensive.
Yeah, so we put that on the top. Honestly, I don't know that it helped that much.
I think it helped a little.
Yeah, but we still, on the good windy days, there's still on smoke.
Still a backdraft.
Backdraft.
Yeah. So we said earlier that we thought we had about $1,000 in the pipe. I feel like we're probably closer to about 15
that,
now.
Yeah,
I think
with that,
when you consider the cost of the double insulated pipe.
Triple insulated.
It's a triple wall double insulated.
I'm sorry. Okay. Triple wall pipe.
Triple wall pipe that is run up the back of the house. The new expensive vacuum stack that we had to switch to in a free stove. There's much cost. When you think about somebody saying, oh, here's a free stove, and you're like, yes, the electric bill has been so expensive. Let's install a stove.
Right.
The cost stacked up quickly. We didn't realize how expensive that pipe was going to be. So the wood we burned back in the spring, someone had given us a load of wood.
Mm-hmm.
That was so nice.
Yeah.
Because when we went to cut wood over the weekend, we realized how nice that gift was. Because cutting wood over the weekend,
it's labor.
Labor intensive. It's going to be an all-day project.
Yes, it is a huge tree. It's going to be
many
firewood.
Many loads.
That we'll split with a friend.
Blew the tire on the trailer on the way home.
Tire problems seem to be a trend.
All that being said, are you happy with the stove?
Yeah.
I'm super happy with the stove.
Well, I mean, you figure whatever we spent on the pipe. I mean, we cut, so just say we ran that fire for, we did a fire for 4 months.
Really, just probably 3 months.
Okay, 3 months in a year. We cut our electric bill from, I'm going to say on average, $350 down to $150, so $200 a month, so $600 a year in savings on energy cost, right off the bat.
Lawson got very good at starting fires for me.
Pieces of wood going under where the pipe is,
mm-hmm.
so it will draw better,
mm-hmm.
and then you put the fire starter under there and light it, and then put like bark mm-hmm. under it, and you have to make sure the wood is dry so it will catch. After it gets going a little good, like the pieces like this are going, then you can throw like tougher pieces that will last longer in, like this.
Yeah, he's...
I am terrible at starting fires. We went camping one time, just the kids and I thought we're gonna starve. I mean, you know, we could have gone down to Chick-fil-A, but we were in the woods and I wanted to grill some chicken or whatever I had taken for us to eat. It took 45 minutes for me to start a fire. And so now we've got this stove. I could just like say like, Lawson, go start a fire. He's on it. Thank goodness. Because we would starve and freeze if it were up to me.
Oh, come on.
It's a good thing we don't live on the prairie.
So in the video, you'll see how hard they worked to turn this old rusty stove insert into a freestanding stove.
Okay, that's the flue. That's the back of it where you're trying to open the
Yeah.
We just need to have somebody weld on like some sort of flange there for the pipe. Because normally this would be
where
an insert.
These?
So that's like a brush attachment for a drill that you can like help get the rust off. I mean, it doesn't look like much right now, but oh my. I cannot wait. Can y'all?
Yeah, but I can't get this open right here. Can't get this one open. Can't get this one open.
Well, it's because it's rusted.
Do we need to put liquid ranch right there?
Yeah, we'll have to put liquid ranch on it too. Look how big it is in there.
I know.
I mean, it is a big wood stove. Yep. Good breezy day, the best day that we know to paint this stove. We've already put a little bit of the really, really happy with how this turned out.
Feed on your body to muster enough weight to make it go.
Come on, put your back in it.
Oh. And that's what's happening to you.
Good job. Maybe you can ask Santa.
Woo! That looked easy.
Pawpaw's making it look easy. Not the first time he's done this, is it?
There'll be enough for you.
And we have just started the first fire in our new wood stove. We've been working on this wood stove for, I don't know, maybe like 2 or 3 weeks. It was gifted to us. It's a wood stove insert. It's like a fireplace insert, but we've converted it to a freestanding stove. And we just started the first fire, and it is drawing really well. If you guys can see that. So this piece here on top, this was an addition. That wasn't there before. It was just the damper that would go up into a fireplace flue. Okay, so the reason that we decided that we would go ahead and start our first fire outside is because we wanted to see how well it would draw, but we also wanted to get it pretty hot and burn off any kind of fumes that may come from me painting it with the oil.
Look at them streaks.
Yeah, I mean, out in the sun you can kind of see all the blemishes from the paint, but inside I don't think it'll be that bad.
I used the a car jack to jack the stove up.
To swirl it around.
To move it across the room. So.
Yeah, that was a genius idea.
I'll do that from time to time.
Okay, this is working out-ish. We're using the car jack. Gonna have to spin it. Yep, keep spinning.
I was secure warm to this wall right here.
So, I'm supposed to do this now.
How's it getting?
Guy that welded on the legs and the flange didn't charge anything, which was super awesome.
My goodness.
Pay for the metal. So even the upgrade to the stove was free. We're blessed to know a lot of good people and have a lot of good connections. And that's the beauty of this farmsteading, farm life is you get to know your neighbors, you get to know your community, and everybody helps everybody.
Yeah.
That's just the reality of things.
Yeah, we definitely could not have done this without that.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Like, we couldn't have done, I mean, he was up here when we knocked the hole in the wall and lifted you on the fork so that you could get the pipe up and install that. I mean,
yeah.
He gave us the stove. I mean,
right.
If it hadn't been for Dad, we wouldn't even have one. Okay, guys, thanks so much for watching. We appreciate all of our new subscribers. Glad to have you with us. If you like this video and you like the things that we're doing here on our farm, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell so that you know when we post a new video, and share this with your friends. And we will see you in the next one. Have a blessed day.
Bye.
Bye.